Hey guys, welcome to the next episode of Pikmin. Today, we are doing the Citadel of Spiders, so it's the goal. I see you, Skiddly. Can't hide. For a citadel of spiders, there aren't a lot of spiders. Thinking of the other. Let's move on to the next sub. It's a goal. That white Pikmin took too long, so he floated. Over here, Wally Brawl. Dang. Guess we should swarm. We should use the trump card, Purple Pikmin. That is the battle's trump card. It will defeat probably any enemy. Well, almost. Certainly do a good job. Purple Pikmin are very powerful, and they can stun the enemy. Which is why, if I'm having trouble, I could just use that. Speaking of Purple Pikmin, we're about to get some. We'll be getting you after we finish this sub-level, though. Purple Pikmin have a 100% chance of, stunning Dweevers, little ones. See how easy it was to defeat that yellow Wally Wall? Oh yeah, I almost forgot. Dweebles like to pick up treasure. With that, they cannot be damaged, but they can be damaged, but they won't lose any HP. They probably do it for protection. Let service. Basically a lipstick. Well, purple Pikmin are probably the best Pikmin for attacking anything. Pikmin 3, purple Pikmin are quite the same, except they have now lost some attack power, making red Pikmin more powerful. However, I've never seen them stun an enemy before. Pretty sure they can because they still do that stomp, but I haven't really seen it happen. So I don't know. Yeah, there's our first thing. Pikmin are suffering, burning to death, basically. That's what it is. I saved them. That's not it, though. This rubber ducky, which is a head, it's called the Paradoxal Enigma. I don't know how the heck they came up with a name like that, but I guess it worked. Buds, they're getting better. Over here, Pikmin. Oh yeah, I forgot. I have no Pluckaphone. That's why I always do the submerged castle early. Can't stand having to pluck Pikmin 1, there's nothing to help you in Pikmin 2, use a Pluckaphone. In Pikmin 3, there's nothing to help you, but you don't have to repeatedly mash the button to pluck Pikmin. Just have to press one button, then they'll pluck all the Pikmin nearby. Yeah. That's what I like about Pikmin 3. So far, we've only seen, like, 3 spiders. Not even that much. Here we have a node beetles. They share electricity with their fellow teammates. Of course, electricity is a big threat. However, they can be defeated easily. On my previous Let's Play, the submerged castle was the third cave I completed in the perplexing pool. The fourth cave was the shower. That cave is good because that is one of my favorite songs in the entire game. Tiles 2. I also like Men 2 and the whole of Heroes. Jeez, these are a lot of enemies. Okay. Now we can start taking back everything. Enemies. Quite a lot of them. It's lucky, we're lucky that they don't weigh much. Okay. This is Sunlight Water Chestnuts Can Patience Tester. We're off to a great start. Repaying the debt. Heck, we're almost there. Just 5,000 more Pokos left after we finish this 4,000. However, that is not all the treasure. There is more. So we'll be searching around for that. Not over here, it seems. Yep, over here. It's underground completely. White Pikmin, it's your job. It's like a seashell. It's probably what it is. Let's head for the treasure in this cave. Delve deeper with all the Pikmin. Ivory candy pop bud. Straight some red, says usual. Sorry, those flowers. Red flowers. Eric Cromed has a treasure on this. You got yourself here. You just meant to fight to water temple. Oh, my God. Yeah, hermit crawmads are the only enemies in Pikmin that their size are is randomly chosen. God, got him. It's rather easy to defeat it. All you must do is really... Ooh, here's a favorite treasure of mine. It's the Flame of Tomorrow. Look, try to guess why I like it. Yes, it has Bowser on it. In the actual Japanese version, that was just some matches that has random company name things, something like that. In this version, same with the decorative goo and the... I forgot the other one, but it was the Mario Paint. Peach Paint. See, as you can see, it's actually a match in there. These are match. Bowser, Breath Paint, Tapone, 555 Troopers. Same with decorative goo and the other object. I think those Master's Instruments. They were just a fake company brand in Japan. They changed it to Mario. International releases, I should say. Releases other than Japan. First, we're carrying everything back for Pokos. Flash Mario coins. I don't see anything else. These guys have progressed to Bud State. Exit's over there. Oh, freaking water dump. Ate the first white Pikmin. As I said in an earlier episode, white Pikmin poison enemies when they eat them. Yep, they have venom inside their bodies. Let's forget about them. We won't give much Pokemon. Plus, we got a bunch of other enemies. Citadel of Spiders above 5, the last. It's also, it's one of the few boss floors that have an extra treasure. Can you find anything? I mean, I know there's treasure here. I Right here? Okay. Give me nectar, give me stuff. Ultra spicy nectar. It gives you one ultra spicy spray. Yes, I have. During the first boss, remember? There's also an ultra bitter spray which turns enemies into stone for 8 seconds. It also reduces defense for enemies, but increases defense for bosses. Anyway, this boss is another boss from Pikmin 1. Albeit just like the Bronze Snagrit, easier. We have the Beanie Long Legs. Let's use just yellow paper. It is easier because the way he moves is more predictable. He drops the key. Sweet victory, the giant insect's body has come to dust. Quite rude, now I want it. Sorry, glittering widget. It's a key. As you might have saw in challenge mode, this is the key from challenge. Guess what happens when you collect the key in story mode for the first time. Okay. So I would combine it with the presence parallel dimension controller. Centers in the game, massive dimensional shift at distant location. Sending message from far-flung dimensions. Playing message now. Challenge mode can now be accessed from the title screen. Here's the total gibberish. Hopefully the message has reached its intended recipient. That would be me, the player. I will name this apparently worthless device the key. Yep. So after getting that, you unlock challenge mode. Well, I already unlocked challenge mode, so that does nothing. Yeah, challenge mode is not initially accessible when you first start playing. The cave is complete. Now then, back to the perplexing pool. Oh, I think I bumped the camera. The camera's fine. Okay. No, we're not quite done yet. Yeah. all of our Pikmin. There's a final cave. We need to do. Hold on. Maybe we here and hopefully we can call Pikmin.
Okay.
Now we're gonna need to go up. Scale time. Will you stop? Go up here. Help you out a bit. Hopefully, we can do this. Possible to call them. We tried. Six yellow volleyballs and one fiery gold blast. His report found quite a bit of treasure. Increased the Pikmin count to 100. Next episode, we will be going to the Awakening Wood to retrieve blue Pikmin, so see you then.